You want to support Roller March Unfiltered? Be sure to join our Bring the Funk fan club. Every dollar that you give to us supports our daily digital show. There's only one daily digital show out here that keeps it black and keep it real. It's Roland Martin Unfiltered. Support the Roland Martin Unfiltered daily digital show by going to RolandMartinUnfiltered.com. You can make this possible. And right now, I want to talk with the Lieutenant Governor of Michigan, who joins us right now, Lieutenant Governor Garland Gilchrist. How you doing?
I'm good, sir. Welcome to Detroit.
All right, so just so y'all know, let me get right in this seat right here. We were in Florida on Saturday and Sunday, Florida Rights Restoration Coalition. Then, of course, we were in Columbia, South Carolina on Monday with Jamie Harrison. Then on Tuesday, yesterday, we were in Atlanta with Joe Biden. I didn't mind any of that at all. And then, but we realized we were coming here. I had to pack these damn hoodies. There's a reason why I left Chicago after 6 years. I do not like coming to the Midwest between the months of October and June 2nd. But we're here. I have not worn a wool cap the entire year. In summer, fall, but I had to bring one out here, and thank goodness I had my Black Voters Matter one. And they actually were here yesterday in Detroit. They are in Flint, Michigan today. I talked to Latasha Brown and Cliff Albright, and so I look forward to seeing them tonight. So, Lieutenant Governor, let's talk about what's happening. I just finished talking with Congresswoman Ilhan Omar about Minnesota, but also Muslims. This state has a huge Muslim population. How do you believe the attacks from Donald Trump on Muslims is going to play in this election? He won last time around by winning this state, not by a very large margin. So just share with us again your perspective of what's happening here.
Well, first of all, it's good to have you here in Michigan. That hat looks really good on you.
Hey.
Real good, don't it?
It's warm, too. Just letting y'all know. It's warm, too.
So, you're right. Trump won this state by the slimmest margin of any state in the country, 10,704 votes. I think it's going to be different this year in Michigan. I think that we made it easier to vote in 2018. We made it easier for people to vote absentee, made it easier for people to register to vote. And I think that's going to lead to historic voter turnout here in this election. So what's going to happen with there, even in the Black community, like here in Detroit, in the Muslim community in Dearborn and other parts of our state, we're going to see turnout that's going to send this hateful president home.
I want to pick up on that point there, because when you say we made it easier to vote, that only happened because the state elected a Democratic governor, Democrat lieutenant governor. And what folks, I keep telling people all around the country, we can't think about politics only from the perspective of what's happening in Washington, D.C. What happened in 2008, massive turnout in this country for then Senator Barack Obama. Folks did not turn out in 2010. That's how Republicans took over 16 state legislatures. That's when they began passing onerous voter ID laws. We can't ignore what happens on the state level. This election, Texas, if Democrats pick up 9 seats in Texas, they win the Texas House first time in 20 years. They could win the House in Arizona. They could actually stop some other places as well. And so those state races are just as important, because that's where the tone is set when it comes to voting.
Roland, we can win the House here with only 4 House seats. There's only 4 House seats we need to flip the Michigan House of Representatives.
And when was the last time the Democrats controlled the House or the Senate here?
That was the House and the Senate?
The House or the Senate.
That was more than 10 years ago.
Got it.
So we have work to do right now. We have a path to it. Because frankly, in 2018, we showed what the path to victory was. Because y'all remember Gretchen Whitmer and I won the election in 2018, right? The reason that we did that is because we had a ground game that was thanks to the Michigan Democratic Party, the organizers, the allied organizations that are represented here in this audience. We knocked doors, we made calls, we continued to do that all the way since 2016. After the victory in 18, we never stopped. And so that's why we built those relationships that have worked even this year when we had to put it on pause because of the pandemic. That's what's going to get us the victory for those 4 House seats. We have a chance to flip the Michigan Supreme Court to get a Democratic majority there. Every election on the ballot matters here. So we're not only going to re-elect Joe Biden and Kamala Harris. We're going to send Gary Peters back to the Senate. We're going to flip the State House and the Supreme Court. We're going to have a lot of leverage for Democrats to do big things.
One of the things that we have been looking at is polling data in this state. We've been talking about this across the country, about what is happening, especially with black men. In this particular, in the Senate race you're talking about, the last poll that was produced, black men was around 17% for John James. And then we saw the same, 14% for Tom Tillis in North Carolina. It was very interesting. I went to the John James website. There's no mention anywhere on his website he's a Republican. I went through the whole website. You swear he's running black.
There ain't a lot on that website, period.
So, what is happening in this state in terms of really, because look, you got some folks who say, hey, I want to support the black man for the United States Senate. I make the point, though, he also made it clear that he supports Donald Trump 2,000%. So if you vote for John James, you're essentially voting for Mitch McConnell.
John James has no plan for black Michigan or black America, period. The reason that I have made it my mission to organize black men across this state, I marched 200 black men to the polls in Detroit two Saturdays ago. I marched black men to the polls in Flint, Saginaw, Benton Harbor, and every place in between. We are going to have record black male voter turnout here this election because, again, we can go vote now. We can go vote now in Michigan because the voters decided that we needed to be able to vote now and vote early. So I think what you're going to see is black men recognizing their power. We've never had so many campaigns speak so directly to black men in our history. God bless our sisters. You have built the political power to have the leverage to have campaigns speak to you. Now it's time for black men to step up. And as a black man, as the highest ranking black elected official in the history of the state of Michigan, I think it is my responsibility to make sure that our power is felt. And it will be felt now and always. So that's the difference that we're going to make here in the state of Michigan.
All right, then. Last question for you. And when we talk about election is one thing, but I keep making the point to my audience that is what you also do after the election. Earlier you said y'all didn't stop organizing. And I think that is a lesson for many African-Americans. And let's just be honest, and people could disagree all you want to, but y'all know I'm not lying. Obama wins in 2009. I argued that black people were the only folks who stayed at the inauguration parade when everybody else left. That we were so excited to see a black first family, we forgot that we said, oh, he's the first black president. We forgot he's the 44th president. Everybody else made demands. Everybody else had an agenda. And so I keep saying we have to keep pushing after the election. And so Biden-Harris wins. They must understand we are going to be right there saying, you said you were going to do this, 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 this. We expect to see this, 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 this. And the same goes for Senator Gary Peters and for anybody else who's running. If you make promises, we expect you to keep them.
All right, well, all of y'all know and have seen over the last 2 years what happens when you elect Democrats to office in Michigan. We elected Democrats all the way across the top of the ticket. And we've had some historic wins. Y'all know about clean slate? Automatic record expungement, the most progressive package in the country to clear people's criminal records. That's something that I worked on and led personally, that we got that for second chances for people in the state of Michigan. The state of Michigan has been the leader in responding to racial disparities and coronavirus. That virus was killing our people at five times the rate it was killing everybody else. We've been able to flatten those disparities because the state of Michigan, Democrats, focused on it. John James and the Republicans, they have one plan. Their plan is to wait for you to die, whether it's due to the pandemic, whether it's due to your health care in general, whether it's due to the economy, whether it's due to our education system. They want to wait for people to die. But Democrats aren't going to wait for people to die. Instead, we're going to organize. And when we win, we continue to work. And that's what's going to keep us going forward.
All right. Lieutenant Governor Gilchrist, I certainly appreciate it. Thank you so very much.
Thank you, sir.
All right. I appreciate it. Thank you very much.
All right, folks. Back to our Rolling Mark Unfiltered video in just one moment. All right, folks, at Seek.com, black-owned company founded by Mary Spio. They, of course, a virtual reality company. You can check out their content at Seek.com, C-E-E-K.com. You can do so, of course, with these VR headsets. You can look at it, of course, on your regular device or your pad or your computer. But if you want to experience being in the room, you can use this headset right here. All you simply do is just pop in your cell phone in here, pop it on, and then put this headset on, and you can literally experience their content in virtual reality. reality. And so allows for you to do a 360-degree view of the room. But also, folks, they have the 360-degree 4D headphones right here. These are Bluetooth headphones. They have complete surround sound in terms of as you hear the particular music. Gamers love them as well when they're playing their games. And so it's just phenomenal bass in these headphones as well. You can get one or both devices at Seek.com using this promo code RMVIP2020, RMVIP2020. So we certainly thank the folks at Seek.com for being a partner with us here at Roland Martin Unfiltered.